Morning, everyone. The plan was to do 10 sets of squats, dynamic effort fashion, and then go outside and do sled drags and farmer carries. But it's raining out, and the ground's pretty icy. So I'm gonna eat breakfast, and then see what happens after I squat. Hopefully I can do something strongman-like. It's getting kind of close, so keep you informed.
And his own story was as curious as his narrative. The tale of his life is the tale of a writer of incredible vision, an astute analyst and pundit, a lyricist compassionate and callous, a reckless hedonist, and disaffected malcontent.
I spit that Wonder Rhyma shit, me and my conglomerates shall remain anonymous.
So, I got my BCAAs, I just made a video, but my stupid camera died again. I was just saying this has citrulline malate, which is good for like muscle endurance, your L-carnitine, tartrate, which is good for muscle strength and endurance. It's got your BCAAs complex, your leucine, which is the most important one because that's what's going to give you the best results for your protein. It's got the isoleucine, the valine, all three of those are your branched chain amino acids. Those are the ones that bind to the skeletal muscles. Your glutamine, which is what it is. This thing doesn't focus. Your glutamine, they say it's good for gut health, but I don't really have an opinion on that right now. And then HICA, your leucic acid. So all I was really saying was that your leucine is the most important branched chain amino acid because it's gonna allow you to get the most out of your protein. It's gonna let you bind the protein molecules and amino molecules together. And then also with your creatine, you should be able to buy that for about $10 or $12 for a big pouch, like 1,000 grams of it or whatever. Don't quote me on that, but it shouldn't be expensive. Your monohydrate is going to be your cheapest version, and then the buffered creatine is going to be the best version. So if you can find either of those, I would suggest doing that. Use the creatine. Abuse it. It's good for your brain. It's good for your muscles. So some people hate supplements. I'm not really sure why. They say it's shit, but it's like saying you don't eat steak either. I don't get it. So anyway, hope that helps.
Plane shot down like John McCain. It's a dream. It's a dream. The flow's elegant like Miss Coretta Scott King. A lot of kings sing deaf and turn queen. Crack they 24-inch rims in the ravine. Respect the architect, never test the Elohim. Good night, this is JLX live from New Orleans. New Orleans.
My journey has brought me to an understanding of the divine forces with which we have all been bestowed. It was in this search that I came upon a revelation which has called me to guide millions of people towards their righteous destiny.
And on the seventh day.
Yeah. Oh, what is up, everyone? Hope you're all doing well. Staying strong, training hard, eating a lot. Today was a dynamic effort squat day. In between my squats, you know I always superset kettlebell swings. Today I did single arm swings, hand-to-hand swings, so five each arm, alternating each swing. I wanted to get some strongman training in. I wanted to do some backward sled drags, but that wasn't happening outside. So I took my sandbag, and I made a loading platform. I did 5 reps, and then I did 10 reps, and then I did 15 reps. And it was a lot harder than it used to be. So, you know, got to work on that a little bit. I'm in the process of letting an Atlas stone cure up. I was making the Atlas stone, and I had it all filled up, and I was just jamming the stick down in there to shake out the bubbles, and ended up separating the two halves from each other. So the concrete kind of spilled out. I managed to get most of it, you know, a little bit spilled out, but I managed to get most of it back into the, trough or something. So anyway, had to clean it off, start over. It doesn't take long to put the concrete in the Atlas stone, but it's just a pain in the ass, you know. Big thing when loading those sandbags is to reach over the top of the stones. Reach over the top and pull it close like you do in a upright row. And that way you're not just using your biceps and your arms and your lower back. You actually use your full back and triple extension. So anyway, instead of doing farm or carry walks, I ended up doing these standing ones, just lifting the knee to still get that hip shift and stabilize the hips. My forearms were burning, and I did about 100. I did 100 steps, 3 times, so 300 steps total, 3 sets of 100, whatever. Then I did these curls with a pause right at the top or right at the beginning. I did some dumbbell curls before that, but you've all seen that, so I wanted to show some farmer curls.
So once you wipe down the inside of the Atlas stone with a rag, take some silicone spray, could be just your regular pan, spray the inside of it pretty thoroughly.
And then basically you just stick the stick down there and let it kind of ride down the stick and pour all the cement in. Like the video if you like the video. I appreciate you guys watching as always.